Hey everyone, Jason Shepard here of MzeroA.com. Last week, if you didn't see last week's video, there's a link below. Last week we planned a great IFR cross country from Melbourne up to the Ocala Airport, and we did it all on 4Flight. Let me recap for you on the iPad. So remember, we departed Melbourne. Our clearance was to fly to Deary, Victor 537, which we programmed all in here, all the way up to Ocala, and I added in and overlaid the RNAV GPS runway 18 approach, because I believe that's the approach we're going to shoot in, again, assuming because it's an IFR day. So we have all of it there. And again, we always say the airplane is a terrible classroom. So don't only learn everything we can on the ground, but prepare everything ahead of time on the ground. So with that in mind, Avidyne, which we fly all Avidyne, has a great Ifd Trainer app for iPad that lets us practice on the ground before we even make it out to the airplane. So you heard me say before, learn everything you can on the ground, and then we can demonstrate it out in the airplane. So let's take the same route, and let's now show that in the Avidyne. So I'll go over to the Ifd Trainer app, and you can see I already have everything all set up over here. I've got us on the map page here, getting rid of our few little alerts and setting all of that up. Now I want to head on over to my FMS, my flight plan page, and I'm going to program all this in. What I'm going to do is I'm going to tap on the black screen there, and I'm going to put my origin in. I'm tapping where it says origin, and it knows my origin is MLB. It's where I'm departing from. It's where my aircraft in this simulation is actually located at. And I'm going to go ahead and press enter. Then what's next? It told me to fly to the Deary intersection. So again, I'll tap just below that white line there in the black portion of the screen. It's a waypoint, so I'll push the waypoint there and I'll type in Deary. I don't have to type in much because it knows the waypoints that are close to me. All I do is type in DE, and it's looking for the nearest waypoints to me that meet that spelling. There's Deary, I'll press enter. Now this is where it gets interesting. Remember in the 4Flight video, Victor 537 has a lot of dog legs at different intersections. Well, previously we would just type in each intersection, it changes its heading. Not so anymore. So if I tap below that white line, below Deary again, you can see I can choose a waypoint to hold at Deary, to orbit Deary, or it knows all the airways that are associated with Deary. And sure enough, there's Victor 537. So I add Victor 537. It's now asking me, where do I wish to exit Deary at? Well, remember, I can take this all the way down to, I could choose just OCF, I could choose Vanny, which was along our route. Knowing that I want to shoot the approach, I'm going to choose to exit Victor 537 at the Vanny intersection. Now again, let me go back here a second, back over to 4Flight to show why I did that. Because remember here, we have Deary to Presk to Sermo, all on Victor 537, to Vanny. Now my clearance was Victor 537 to Ocala, but you and I all know we eventually have to shoot an approach in there. So as I get closer, Jack's approach is going to ask me, what approach do I want? So I'm programming this, thinking ahead to the approach that I want. So Vanny's right along my route because it continues on to OCF, and by that point, either at that point or before, I'm hoping to have vectors to where I'm going next, which is Salmu, as you can see there. Again, who names these intersections here? Salmu is where I'm looking to head. So let's go back over to our trainer app, and you can see I've exited at Vanny here. Now I'm going to go ahead and tap to add something else. I'm going to add another waypoint. Now it's important in the Avidyne, so we don't have a gap in route, that I actually add Salmu as my next intersection. And what was it? S-O-W, I believe. There it is. S-O-W, Salmu. Enter. And I'll explain why in just a second. And then we're going to go ahead, add a waypoint, and it's going to be K-O-C-F, not just O-C-F there. So I have all of that set up. Now, I want to go ahead, now that Ocala is selected here and it's at the bottom, I'm going to press the procedure button on the right-hand side of the screen. Procedure. I'm going to choose the RNAV 18. I'm going to tap on that. I want to pick it up at Salmu, as you can see there. Pick it up at Salmu and press enter. Now when I go back to my route here, I can see from Vanny, and see how it puts that all on Victor 537, to Salmu, and then into Kufjo Luggy, QM and then runway 18 all the way in. And then after I arrive at Ocala, it also has the published missed approach in there for me. One thing I love about Avidyne is the moment I go around and it sees I'm gaining some altitude, it just loads it. There's no suspend approach or anything like that. It's going straight missed. The Avidyne's always thinking ahead, and a good IFR pilot is always thinking ahead. Never just assume you're gonna have a nice easy landing. Always think ahead and assume you're going to go missed. So I have all of this. I can now pull this up on the map here and I can see MLB, Tadiri as my active route shown in the magenta. My next route here, you can see all the way up to Presque, flying on over here past MCO up to Sermo, all the way on up to Vanny. Now, I went, remember I put in the plan Vanny to Salmu. If I didn't do that, if I just chose to go procedure or Vanny Ocala procedure, I would have what's called a gap in route, meaning this leg from Vanny to Salmu wouldn't exist because it would just start the approach at Salmu, but it wouldn't know how I was going to actually arrive there. So remember I made a point to say I'm going from Vanny, I'm putting in Salmu, even though I know it's an initial on my approach, then Ocala, and then procedure and loading the approach from Salmu, because I have to have a leg. I have to get to Salmu somehow in the GPS's eyes from Vanny to Salmu. And then it shows my approach all the way on in, as you can see there. The power of learning everything we can on the ground. I did all my flight planning in ForeFlight. I got, you know, my practice clearance. I went to the Ifd Trainer app on iPad and just planned it all out. This is something you can be sitting on the couch, planning fictitious flights, loading it into your trainer app and practicing. Because when the engine's running in front of you and the Hobbs meter is ticking and you're number 3 for departure and ATC just changed your route and you plan this beautiful flight, but they say, hey, 2-3 Mike Zulu, I have an amendment to your route. That happens in IFR flying. We can plan the most beautiful route, just have it changed. We need to know how to make these changes and make these updates. Again, this simulator here too, you can actually fly, you can change your airspeed, you can do whatever you want to act truly simulate. It's a very, very cool piece of software. Listen, I hope you'll come and visit us at Sun and Fun. We're in Hangar D, Booth 92. Hangar Delta, Booth 92. Myself and the MzeroA.com team will be there all week, and I can't wait to meet you, shake your hand, and hear what you're doing in aviation. Also, September 21st and 22nd in Dallas, Texas, is Aviation Mastery number 2. If you want to learn more about ForeFlight, Avidyne, Garmin, in-flight emergencies, just being that safer, smarter pilot who's always learning, come join us in Dallas, Texas, September 21st and 22nd for Aviation Mastery. Links to all this and everything I've mentioned are below in the description as well. Enjoy the rest of your day, and most importantly, remember, the good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya. I sincerely hope you loved watching this video. These videos you see online are simply just the tip of the iceberg of what we do here at MzeroA.com. MzeroA is a complete private, instrument, commercial, and FOI online ground school. Everything is done at your own pace online. You watch our lessons, also online, take practice exams, all from any device. If you love these free videos we put out here on YouTube and Facebook, I encourage you to check out our complete online ground school for the knowledge test, check ride, and most importantly, setting you up to make you that safe real-world pilot. Take a 2-week free trial, no strings attached, of our online ground school by visiting mzeroa.com/trial.